Hey everybody, welcome back to the Plays and Fades YouTube channel. I'm your host, Gordo Gambles, joined by this beauty of a man, Kirode, and we're here after a excruciating week off with no fights, man. We're back, 15 fight slate, Smith versus Spence main event. How are we feeling?
I mean, we feel good. There wasn't a UFC night last weekend, which sucked, but there was a lot of football action this weekend. Oh. This guy spent all of Sunday sitting on the couch, watching the TV, flipping back from 30 games back and forth to one another. And yeah, it was a good time. NFL starting, we're excited about that. But obviously we're even more excited about there being a UFC card this weekend. It's a fight night. It's not a particularly exhilarating one, but it's UFC happening again. I mean, Spann versus Smith, in the wise words of Conor McGregor.
Who the fuck is that guy? Who the fuck is that?
It's not the greatest card of all time. We're really excited for the card next weekend. Obviously, that's a huge one that's been highly anticipated for a long time. But this weekend, we do have a lot of people that we really like. I mean, it's a good card for betting. It's a good card for DFS. And we're excited to talk about it today.
You know what? What usually happens with these low-level fighter cards is we see a lot of finishes. And that's what we love to see in DFS, is just because the more finishes, the more points, the more money is made. And if you look at 2 weekends ago, you see our video. Paddy Pimblett goes out there, starches him. Jack Shore, with a torn bicep, destroys him.
Yeah.
We did really, really well, and we're ready to do even better today. I say we don't waste any more time. Let's get right into it. The first person I want to talk about is going to be a pay-up option. There are so many favorites on the slate, minus 700s, minus 550. The guy I'm targeting the most, 9.5K, Montel Jackson. I mean, this guy's an absolute killer, but tell me why I want to have him in our lineup this week.
Montel Jackson, second highest salary on the card this week, but we like him anyway because he is a huge favorite in this fight. I mean, the betting lines are minus 550. This guy's gonna win this fight, and we really like him this week. I mean, honestly, this fight maybe shouldn't even be sanctioned. It's such a mismatch here for Montel. I mean, this is gonna be a tough fight for buys here. He's going up a weight class. He's been finished in his last three fights. This guy is bigger than him, longer than him. I mean, just about every advantage you could have in the book Jackson has here in this fight, and that's why he has that $9,500 price tag. But this is such a mismatch in our eyes that we think you have to have this guy. We're not going to say the L word.
No, never.
But it's in the back of the mind there.
I mean, you look at a guy in JP Bays, and whereas I do think he has some decent potential in the UFC, it's not of this division, and it's against some a lot lower levels of competition than Montel Jackson. Montel Jackson's able to finish this anywhere he wants, and I truly do think it's going to be a finish. Again, all three losses for JP Bays have been by finish. Let's make it a fourth right here.
All right, that's our first big high salary of the night. Who's the first person that we like with a low salary?
I mean, with a 15 fight slate, you have such a wide variety of price ranges. In this case, we have someone in Carlton Harris who's sitting at a price tag of 7.3K, who isn't really deserving of a 7.3K price tag. I mean, this guy's upside is off the charts. You know, I love my wrestlers, I love my Merab Dovalishvili's, and someone like Carlton Harris is someone who is really similar in that pathway. Tons of takedowns, tons of volume. This man is relentless, and the thing with him is he has very, very good cardio. I mean, Cassagne is a great prospect in himself, and I'm really high on him as well, but when you have someone like Carlton Harris who is able to get those takedowns, we've seen Impa Beefers first, control on the ground. I mean, the path to victory is there for Harris. I mean, Impa has not really faced many, many grapplers, so this is going to be a huge test to see where he's at. And when you can get someone with Carlton Harris who has upside to land 10 takedowns, land 12 takedowns, land so many takedowns in the spot, his ceiling is massive. And at 7.3K, it's someone I really, really want to target. If you look at the betting line, that's even coming even closer, so we're getting plus EV here as well. It's just a spot where I'm really liking Carlton Harris. I think he gets it done, and I think he grinds himself out to either a late finish or a victory, because wrestling and cardio are two great components, especially for DraftKings, and those points are going to add up.
Yeah, I mean, we're looking here at more of a GPP play. This guy is not a guarantee at all, even though he does have that path to victory and a huge ceiling at that price tag. He's not necessarily somebody that you're going to be very sure is gonna get the win in this fight.
Yeah, and that's the thing, when you have those 15 fight slates, there's those opportunities to go big because not as many people are gonna be splitting the pot. I say you crank out those GPPs. I have a lot of GPPs on this list of fighters I wanna target right here. So let's go into another one. A relatively safe option because we have this plus EV. We have a short notice replacement for Nicholas Mata, who's sitting at a price tag of 7.9K. Tell me why we like him in this spot.
Mata in this fight is somebody that we see a lot of value on because this guy is a minus 310 favorite in this fight to get the win, but he's sitting there at a 7.9K price tag on DraftKings, which is huge value for us. I mean, his opponent is coming in on short notice, Van Camp, wasn't expected to be his opponent, and that's something that we take advantage of every single time on DraftKings. That always gives us an opportunity to get some value, maybe where we shouldn't because of the way that they set their price tags. So we think this guy has huge potential to finish this fight. He has incredible power, and he's fighting a guy who is also making his UFC debut. So we think there's a lot of value here on this guy. I mean, we expect him to get the win, and at this price tag, he's almost a must-have in a lot of your lineups.
Yeah, he's someone who's relatively safe. However, if we look up GPP options, like we said, the fighter who is probably the most GPP-esque type fighter you ever had is someone like Ian Kutalaba. This guy comes out here, he either starves you in the first round or he gets tired and loses. And that's the thing. We have someone with such a high ceiling, with such a low floor, and that's exactly when they target in GPP plays. Now, like I said, Ian Kutalaba is that guy. I mean, he's sitting out there with a price tag of 9K right now. He's facing a guy in Clark who has been finished in the first round multiple times, and Ian Kutalaba shoots out of a cannon in that first round. I mean, he targets those takedowns, he ground and pounds your face in, but if he can't get you out of there, it's gonna go three rounds, just like it did with Dustin Jacoby his last time out. So I'm really big on Ian Kutalaba this week. I think he's able to put him out there in that first round. I think he's able to score really, really well for us. Now, if you want to be able to afford someone like that GPP play at 9K, someone I really like, sitting at a price tag of 7.4K, is going to be Mike Rodriguez. Now, before I get you started on this, I just want to say, I never thought I'd ever include Mike Rodriguez in one of these videos. I mean, he's probably the most unreliable fighter on the roster. But tell us why we like him.
Yeah, I mean, as you said, Rodriguez, not necessarily a guy we expected to pick in any of these videos just because of his fight IQ being not particularly high. This guy is not the smartest fighter out there, and he kind of lets himself get into some bad situations. But this week, we like him a lot, not only because he has such a low price tag, but because of this matchup that he has against Tefon. I mean, he is bigger than this guy, longer than this guy. He has a few advantages there. And recently, a lot of his fights where he hasn't been particularly smart have been against grapplers, and he's losing a lot when he's not on the feet. But on the feet, he might have the advantage in this matchup here. I mean, he's gonna throw combinations while Inchukwi is not necessarily gonna be doing that. He's gonna be throwing one punch and kind of moving out of the pocket. And we like Rodriguez in this matchup because of that advantage on the feet. He's not a bad fighter on the feet. He just isn't necessarily the smartest fighter all the time. But with the combination of that price tag and this matchup this week, we like him a lot. We think he's one of the smarter dogs maybe to take on this card.
Never thought I'd say that. I mean, the big thing here is Tefon's coming up a weight division. He's gonna have a huge height and reach discrepancy to Rodriguez. And if you're trying to spend up on these big guys, if you're trying to make that GPP play, I mean, Rodriguez has burned a lot of guys in the past and they're probably not gonna play him either. So this is a spot where you might be able to get some low ownership and some high scores on DraftKings.
Yeah, definitely a high ceiling. All right, moving on to one of the last fights we're gonna talk about today. What are your feelings on the main event?
I mean, I think I like Anthony Smith a lot more than a lot of people. I mean, he's getting a lot of hate this week, and I don't know why. I mean, he's a really good fighter. He looked really good his last time out. The problem for him this week is going to be stuffing those takedowns. I mean, we saw Crew be able to take him down with one leg, literally. So if Span's able to do that as well, you never know what's going to happen. The thing with Smith is he's a gatekeeper. He knows what he's going to do, and he is smart. So if he's able to wear on Span, we've seen Span wear out in the past. If he's able to do what he has in the past and really just wear him out to the fourth round and finish him there, Smith has, he's called Lionheart for a reason. He's gonna grind you out. He's gonna be able to finish late. So I do like Smith to win this fight. 9.1K is a bit steep. When you have such a big slate, maybe not the best target, especially when you have guys like Ian Kutalaba who will be boom or bust for you at 9K. So I'm liking Smith in this spot, but I wouldn't mind a shot at Span if he is able to land those takedowns to get him out early. Now, for the rest of the card, the rest of the slate, we have people like the Tony Gravelays with their Monarsuki Tarzukians who will also be great payup options as well. So I don't know if you're gonna be wanting to spend so much on Anthony Smith when there's guys like Sardzukian who are money line value of minus 700 and who are gonna put on a clinic against Christian Jagos, or someone like Tony Gravely who will be able to land 8, 9, 10 takedowns against Nate Maness as well, who should get win as well. If you're looking for some value plays, don't mind Bohm at 8K making her debut. I'm not very high on Lipsky. And you can also look at someone like Rong Zhu to go out there and be a lot better than he was in his first performance. But that's gonna cover it for our slate. Like we said, we like Montel Jackson up top, someone like Carlton Harris in the bottom. Make a bunch of lineups, hit us up on Twitter, hit us up on Instagram. We'll be able to answer your questions and make a lot of money this weekend. I mean, we're hyped. UFC Saturday, NFL Sunday, we're ready to go. So make sure to leave a like on this video, follow our Instagram and Twitters, and let's make some money.